So in 1961, Kuiper wrote an article called The Limits to Completeness, and his first sentence was, "The membership of the solar system is not completely known." It was true then, and it's certainly true now. The Kuiper Belt is, in fact, an endless frontier.
Beyond the familiar boundaries of our solar system lies a vast and mysterious region known as the Kuiper Belt. Stretching far beyond the orbit of Neptune, this celestial frontier holds a wealth of untapped opportunities for humanity's future endeavors. While much attention has been directed towards the asteroid belt, it is the Kuiper Belt that presents a truly captivating prospect for colonization. Join us on a journey to this unexplored realm, where new civilizations may flourish and the limits of human exploration will be pushed to extraordinary heights. Let's begin. When we think about space colonization, our minds often wander to the Moon, Mars, or Venus. But there's a lesser-known frontier that holds incredible potential: the Kuiper Belt. This distant region, located beyond Neptune, is a gateway not just to our solar system, but to the vast expanse of the galaxy itself. So what exactly is the Kuiper Belt? It is a vast donut-shaped region, stretching from 30 to 50 astronomical units, or AU, with one AU being the distance between Earth and the Sun. It's filled with numerous icy objects and minor planets, making it larger in volume than the entire inner solar system. Named after the renowned astronomer Gerard Kuiper, who made significant contributions to our understanding of our own moon and the moons of Neptune and Uranus, the Kuiper Belt remained largely unknown until the discovery of Pluto, its first known object, in 1930. Since then, numerous other objects, including dwarf planets like Orcus, Haumea, Quawar, and Makemake, have been found within its boundaries. The Kuiper Belt is estimated to contain over 100,000 objects larger than 100 kilometers, or 60 miles, in diameter, compared to only about 200 such asteroids in the asteroid belt. These icy bodies, potentially tens of millions in number, offer a wealth of resources and opportunities for future exploration and colonization. However, there are challenges to overcome. The Kuiper Belt receives only a fraction of the sunlight Earth does, making it a dim and frigid environment. Yet, ingenious solutions such as using glass domes, parabolic dishes, or even rotating habitats can provide enough light and create habitable spaces. Additionally, the low gravity found in most asteroids and dwarf planets can be countered through rotation, allowing for comfortable living conditions and easy mining operations. While the Kuiper Belt may not possess the same abundance of resources as Earth, its sheer size and potential dwarf that of the asteroid belt. With its vast icy bodies and untapped riches, this distant region beckons us to venture further into the cosmos. The Kuiper Belt represents a gateway to a new era of exploration, where human civilization may thrive and expand into the depths of our galaxy. If your ultimate aim is to gather resources from planets and construct space habitats and a Dyson swarm in the future, it is essential to consider the potential of mining asteroids as a crucial step towards achieving that goal. Although astronomical scales can be deceptive, even a massive asteroid like Nemesis, which is just a fraction of Earth's mass, holds an enormous amount of raw materials. In fact, it contains over a billion times the mass of the Great Pyramids, and a million times more steel than what we currently produce annually. The main asteroid belt is rich in iron, carbon, water ice, ammonia, and methane, which are abundant resources for building spaceships, space stations, power collectors, and habitats. Although the availability of these resources may be slightly lower in the Kuiper Belt and scattered disk, they still provide ample materials for constructing biocylinders or biorings and filling them with important volatiles necessary for sustaining life. Both the main asteroid belt and the Kuiper Belt, along with the Jovian Trojans, near-Earth objects, and the scattered disk, are significantly smaller in mass compared to the major planets. However, they are much more accessible and contain far greater resources than anything we have ever mined or refined on Earth. To put it into perspective, if an asteroid-like nemesis were to crumble and spread across our planet, it would cover the entire Earth with a layer about 1 meter deep. Similarly, an asteroid or Kuiper Belt object of that size could produce enough cylinder habitats to match the combined total internal living area of the entire Earth. When it comes to colonization and resource acquisition in the outer solar system, the energy source and time frame play crucial roles. While shipping a large comet from the Kuiper Belt, or utilizing moons of giant planets for air and water supply are possibilities, the accessibility and urgency depend on the availability of energy. If artificial fusion power, or an even more advanced energy source, is in use, the energy cost of transporting large amounts of water, ammonia, or methane becomes less significant compared to the potential benefits. Typically, discussions about colonizing the outer solar system revolve around the idea of a fusion economy. However, let's consider the scenario where practical and affordable fusion is not economically viable. In such cases, there are still three possible approaches for colonization without fusion. First, classic nuclear fission could be employed by making use of the abundant uranium and thorium present in the solar system. Alternatively, energy transmission from closer to the sun could be employed, although focusing a beam over long distances becomes increasingly challenging. Energy collectors capable of beaming gigawatts of power across astronomical distances could be constructed, enabling the propulsion of ships and powering stations in distant regions. In terms of colonization feasibility, the distance of the Kuiper Belt and scattered disk from the sun might seem impractical without fusion energy. However, there are ways to overcome this challenge. By using nuclear fission, or beaming energy from closer to the sun, it becomes possible to establish colonies in these remote areas. For instance, a ship accelerated at 1G using a beam could reach Pluto, located in the middle of the Kuiper Belt, in approximately 18 days. Communication times between Earth and the Kuiper Belt range from 4 to 7 light hours, while travel times are around 16 to 20 days. Continuing even further to the Oort cloud would require longer travel times, but with constant acceleration, speeds of up to a quarter of the speed of light could be achieved. While it might be feasible for passenger ships to travel at these high speeds, the return journey would be lengthier or more costly if the return beam and laser for deceleration were generated at the destination. Additionally, this approach would be highly energy intensive. Instead of using lasers as in a beaming method, scientists have come up with another idea for space travel. They suggest gathering all the energy from the sun by creating a thin ball of material around it, like a paper-thin balloon near the planet Mercury. This ball would be about the same weight as a big asteroid and could provide a lot of power. Currently, the utilization of the sun's energy for space travel is still in its early stages of development. This means that the concept is being explored and researched, but it has not reached a mature or widely implemented state yet. In terms of the practical application of this idea, space travel using solar energy would rely heavily on automation. This means that advanced technologies and machines would be responsible for most of the tasks and operations involved in the journey. Additionally, it is important to note that only a small number of people would be living in space during this phase. This indicates that human presence in space would be limited, and the majority of space travel activities would not involve a large population of individuals. In the future, we could establish colonies on asteroids and encircle the sun. By focusing on the polar regions of the sun, where sunlight is not needed, we could harness an incredible amount of power, allowing for efficient space travel. With this abundant energy, a single person's accommodations could power a 10-ton spacecraft. This means that billions of people could travel simultaneously. Even with a growing population, Limitations in this travel method would not arise until the year 3200 CE. By then, we may have advanced solar-powered spacecraft that can move celestial objects like comets, enabling interstellar colonization. To establish colonies, we could use large rocks or ice balls as both shielding during travel and as a source of propellant upon arrival. This approach saves energy and allows for the creation of rotating habitat colonies. If beaming energy proves impractical, alternative propulsion systems like nuclear thermal propulsion or nuclear electric propulsion can be explored. These systems offer high thrust and fuel efficiency for interplanetary and long-duration space travel. In addition, other advanced concepts like antimatter propulsion and fusion propulsion hold promise, but are still in the theoretical stage. As technology progresses, we can expect even more innovative propulsion methods for space exploration. There is no doubt that the future of space colonization holds exciting possibilities. From establishing colonies on asteroids and harnessing the power of the sun, to exploring the depths of the Kuiper Belt, humanity's reach into space is poised to expand. As we overcome the challenges of distance, energy requirements, and propulsion, our capacity to explore and settle new frontiers grows exponentially. The potential for interstellar colonization, resource extraction, and scientific discoveries is immense. The question remains, what other remarkable advancements and opportunities will emerge as we continue our journey into the cosmos? Share your views in comments, like, subscribe, and watch more content like this, here.